one of the things about coming to gym for the first time, particularly if it's January, or maybe you didn't quite get around to January, maybe it's February, is understanding what are the rules of the gym, what's the tips, how should I behave, what's the etiquette. What we can do, give you 10 top tips for how to make the most of the gym, and also how not to. Okay, so first up is a real fundamental one. As much as we don't have swimming pools in the gyms, sometimes people create them with the sweat. Not great, not what you want to see. So all you need to do is bring a little towel. After you finish, give your bench a wipe down, use a sanitizer, it's ready for the next person. It's just polite, it's courteous, it's also hygienic. And one for the guys, it's generally not cool to stare at the girls, but it's especially not good to stare at them when they're on this machine. No staring and definitely no direct eye contact. One of the other things is machine hogging. Generally you want to pick one machine to use at most, and particularly if it's quiet, maybe two. But what you shouldn't be doing is deciding that the whole area is yours. You need to put your mark here and put your scent on it and all this sort of thing. Meanwhile, you're doing this one, and then you're doing, I'm supersetting biceps, I'm doing a bit of calves, I'm on this one as well. Don't touch my machine. It's not a good thing. Pick your machine, and if someone wants, always offer to work in with them. While you're resting, they can do their set, and you can swap back over. Also in the category of machine hogging is texting on the machine. Now, we appreciate you got to update your social media, let all your fans know what you're doing, but save it for after you finish training, get on with your session, and let other people use the machines. Most of our members are all shapes and all sizes, but we do have a few monsters. And one of the rules is, don't stare at the monsters. As much as you might need to look at them and wonder what the hell's going on, they can see you. One of the other big no-nos is screaming while you're lifting. Now you can see most of our members here can lift some seriously heavy weight without letting you know about it. And you hear that, sounds like they're in a maternity ward about to give birth. You don't need it, I don't need it. If a couple of little grunts on your last couple of reps, fine. If you're screaming all the way through, time to go home. One of the other ones that's easy to do when you first start off is getting in someone's eye line. Now these guys and girls have spent years sculpting the guns. The last thing they want you doing is exactly what I'm doing, which is getting in the way and blocking the view of all the gains. It's no good. So if someone's doing a set, stay out of the way, let them finish, and then if you need to go get something, go grab it then. Now this is one of the most basic rules and one of the most commonly broken ones. Putting your weights away. It's really simple. Once you get the weight, you go and use it, do what you need to do, and then when you're finished, not very complicated, you just put it back where you found it. To make this easier for you, what we've done is put the number of the dumbbell next to the position on the rack, nice and straightforward. And one of the other things you shouldn't do is fill the gym, especially the gym floor, with your bags. So while some people look like they're about to move house, you probably don't need it all. You can leave some of it in the locker, otherwise you end up leaving all your shit around. This is all my space, it's no good. Yeah, mate, I've just done 60 minutes on the stairs. I'm really going at it hard, you know. It's one of those things. This is not it. You see people doing this, they're leaning on the machine. It's not really doing very much. If you want to do the dips, do it in the dipping area. The handrails are meant for elderly people to help you get in and out of the machine or stop you losing your balance. So if you're on the machine, hands off and let your legs do the work. So I hope you enjoyed that. A couple of top tips there, both for you to help enjoy your sessions, but for everyone else to help enjoy the gym environment that you're in.